And good evening, everybody. Welcome to Midwest Manager Guy's Sunday night super chill stream. Thought I'd play a little Queensryche tonight with a little IMI. I suppose I should have played Eyes of a Stranger, considering what we're going to be working on tonight, which is a beholder from Westphalia Miniatures. I have I've built up the base on it, gave it a little bit more texture, put some other stuff on it, so let's go ahead and get started. I hope everybody's had a great weekend. I hope everybody is doing well. And gearing up for another week. I had a gig last night with my little country, well, I can't say mine. I backed a local country artist last night with my bass player, John, from the Serfs. Yeah, we had a ton of fun. We played some songs that we don't normally play. So it was fun. I don't know why I have stream ending. I should say stream starting soon. Good grief. What am I doing here? It's like I don't know how to do this anymore. Quick shout out to Vamster75 who subscribed yesterday. I don't know how you do that. But anyway, thank you for this subscription. We are at 5 subscribers out of our goal of 10. Which is super cool. We have a goal of 440 followers. We're at 432 right now. So if you like what I'm doing here and you want to give me a follow, I'd greatly appreciate it. If you really, really like what I'm doing here and you want to give me a subscription, that'd be super cool too. You can use your Amazon Prime. You get one subscription, I think, per month, I believe. I think that's how it works. But if you are so inclined to do so, again, I greatly appreciate it. But let's go ahead and get started. Ooh. There we go. Back to our original positioning here. So this is what we've got. This is the beholder. And I put him on a bigger base because he was very tippy. This is the original base right here. And he's got some skulls and a helmet and a rib cage. But I decided I was going to put him on a bigger base. And this is actually, what am I trying to think of? It's acrylic caulking is what I used. And I just mushed everything down into it. And it hardened up nice. I added some more rocks. I added the axe head. This little, I think this is actually a spearhead, but looks good as a dagger. A couple of old wagon wheels. And I was trying to find some more skulls and stuff, but or bones or whatever, but I really couldn't find anything else. Looks like that's a flail. Looks like there's a handle and a flail on there. So that's interesting. I see a sword right there as well. Right there, but we're gonna go ahead and work on the main figure here. And I, to be honest, I don't know how I want to paint this yet. I primed it up. I got it built. I primed it up on Friday, along with a couple of other figures. But I don't know. We'll see. I got a bunch of paint here. I think we're just going to go for it. I'm going to grab a glove from my left hand here because it's all beaten the heck out of. And I don't want to get any hand oils on the figure as I hold it because it's a little too big for my mini holder. CT Bowden, thank you for the follow. Just followed this minute. So thank you so much. Really, greatly appreciate that. Hope you are doing well. Thank you for watching. Pop open yield. Dealy thing here. What should we paint him? Should we go kind of weird? Let's go weird. I've got some reddish skin here. I think we're going to go... we could go like a reddish orange. Should we do that? Let's see what this looks like. Oh yeah, okay. So I've been using ProAcrylic paints quite a bit. Just what we're kind of sticking with here. I'm trying to stick with stuff that's like already on my palette. So I don't have to grab a whole ton of stuff. And it's fun to try and, well, at least for me anyway, it's fun to try and use what's already on my palette, maybe that I've already used in a different sculpt. But we could do like a bunch of different colors on this guy. Just make him rando. Little bits of skin tone here and there and stuff. I guess I should say Caucasian skin tone. Maybe down around the lips. The eyeball. Try to make sure that we wait for other people to pop in before we get started, but we're just doing base coats right now, so it's no big deal. No big deal. Blah 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 blah. We're just getting started. This is a resin cast. Figure too, so it's got some weird texture to it. I'm always making noises too, by the way. I'm either singing or I'm making weird noises. I don't always, if you're new to the stream, I don't always play music. Sometimes I do. I always try to play at least a song at the beginning, but then just try to keep it fairly mild and chill so that people can ask questions and they're not, you know, I'm not kind of overwhelmed by the music as well, because that can happen. I love music. I'm a musician. I love listening to music and playing it and whatever, but sometimes you just want it to be quiet. I think I want to do these eye stalks multicolors here. If I can try and blend, maybe not all of them, I think just a couple big front ones here. The other ones can be whatever in the back. Do we need to back this off a little bit so we can get more? There we go. And get more in screen. There we go. Maybe we'll look like he's just coming in out of the dark as well. So this will be, the front will be well lit. And the back will be in shadow. I think that's a cool idea. Let's see if we can pull it off. He's also kind of hairy. He's got hair, which is weird. I don't think I've ever seen a beholder with hair before. But he's definitely going into my D&D campaign. Harry Beholder. Harry the Beholder. Since that's still wet, kind of try and blend that down into his face there. So I got home from the gig around 9:15 last night or so, which is super early because normally I'm not getting home till like midnight, 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning normally. So it's kind of nice to be able to get home with the sun just going down and early enough to sit down and watch a movie with Kim. And we ended up watching Days of Future Past, the X-Men movie. I forgot how much fun that movie was. Was it Oscar worthy? No. Was it fun? Yeah. It was an X-Men movie. Expected to be fun. I like the fact that Peter Dinklage is in it as Bolivar Trask. Which gives it all a whole new, you know, because he's been in, I mean, besides Game of Thrones, he was also in the Chronicles of Narnia. He played one of the dwarves in that movie, in, I think it was Prince Caspian? Voyage of the Dawn Treader, I believe. I think he was in that one. I'm going to do purples in the back, purples and blues. So I gotta find some good blues here. I need a dark blue. Yeah, we'll do some red or rich blue. And then we'll do some regal purple. I think the blues were gonna go up top, and then the purples will do down on the bottom here, trying to get like down in the shadows. I need to get a good pile of that going here. But anyway, speaking of Peter Dinklage, not only was he in Days of Future Past, but he was also in was it Infinity War? When Thor gets the axe hammer thing. He plays, again, a dwarf, but like a huge dwarf, like the maker of weapons for the Asgardians, which is pretty cool. Okay, so we're gonna grab some purple. So he's been in a couple Marvel franchises, different characters, which I think is cool. Good for him. I think he's a great actor. I think he's kind of fun. A friend of mine told me that he was in a movie called In Bruges, which I guess was filmed in Brussels, Belgium. I'm like, oh, kind of want to see that. That sounds interesting. What I understand of the premise of that movie is that they play gangsters or hitmen or something like that that are on the run from their bosses or something. They end up in Brussels, hiding away. So like I said, sounds interesting. Zeta Sharky, what's happening? Hecking Meeps, been a sec. Brussels like Brussels sprouts? No. I eat big knobs. Ooh, I do detect a beholder. Yes, we are working on a beholder from Westphalia Miniatures tonight. We're doing it a little bit differently. So the front, jeez Louise, the front here. Wish I could figure out where I'm going to be painting. The front here is going to be lit. So, like, he's coming out of the shadows, right? Towards the adventures, and the back end is going to be in shadow. So, I'm using blues and purples for the back end, and more like reds, red tones up front as he's coming into, like, the lantern light. Don't mind Brussels sprouts. Brussels sprouts are okay. They're just like mini cabbages for the most part. Yeah, we're just trying to get some. Some colors on him right now. How you been, Zeta? What's going on? What have you been up to? Yeah, we'll see if I can pull it off. I hope I can pull it off. Being okay. Okay. It's good. Better than being 6 feet under. Some purple and blue here. Don't ever be afraid to mix colors too. Just shorking about, yeah. Wife and I went, I know this is so very adulty, but my wife and I went riding lawnmower shopping today. So we purchased a new ridey lawnmower. A John Deere. Haven't had a John Deere. Had a the one that I currently own that does not work. That's why we're getting a new one. It will go backwards, but it will not go forwards. It's very odd. It's still going to be in the shadow. Okay. Currently playing Ghost of Tsushima and listening to you, or as I like to joke about, Ghost of Sushi. Ghost of Sushi. Nice. Yeah, it's weird. I have no idea why it will not go forward. I even talked to the people at the hardware store. We went to Home Depot, and then we went to Lowe's. And Lowe's had the better deal and the more experienced and knowledgeable staff. Just kind of surprising. Especially for a kid the same age as my daughter. But he's like, oh, I've been working here for 2 years. Okay, well, you should know what you're talking about then. Before anybody gets like, oh, why are you getting a riding lawnmower? I have a really bad back. In fact, I've been laid up. I can't say laid up, but I've been hurting with a horrible left or right side sciatic nerve issue for like over a month now. And I've worked through it with chiropractic visits and stuff like that, but it sucks. And it's still very hard for me to get out and about to use a push mower anymore. My back is just messed up, can't do it. So that's why. We got a new righty. Yeah, I'm just gonna mix that right in. Do it like so. It's gonna be that, and that's gonna be still back in shadow as well. I hear Ghost of Tsushima is really fun. I haven't played it yet, but I hear it's really fun. Thought about picking it up, but I've been trying not to purchase too many other video games. I need to go back and replay some that I just kind of blew through. Like Horizon Zero Dawn, I want to go back and replay that. And then Horizon Forbidden West. And I kind of want to go back and redo the Uncharted, replay the Uncharted series, because that was a ton of fun, and The Last of Us. I saw Orcish, another Twitch streamer, was playing The Last of Us Part 1, and I kind of want to go back and play those again, because some of those are just jump scares to beat the band, and it's not even like like, the zombies are in it, right? But they aren't, like, the main story. Like, the monsters that are part of that story are literally the humans. And you're like, oh, yeah, human beings. Freaking jerks. Out for themselves. Surprise, surprise. Zombies don't care. They're dead. They just have to eat brains. Zombies are like, this is just all about the friends we've made along the way. Both amazing titles. They are. Yeah, they're a ton of fun. I'm going more. Yeah, we'll go fleshy this way. Fleshy, fleshy. Some fleshy in there. Fleshy down here. fleshy in like here. I could always add in some yellows and such. Okay, I think that's kind of a good start. The other thing I've been working on is a white dragon that's definitely going into my D&D game. For sure. And I will show you it in just a moment here so you can see what I've been working on. It's a little big, which was why I didn't want to try and do it on stream. I guess it's not super big, but it's more cumbersome. And so it'd be a little bit difficult to do on stream. Grime this up a little bit too. Grimy, grimy. Yeah. Beholder living in a cave. Grimy. Doesn't have, to an extent, doesn't have room service. You know, he's got to wait for the meals to appear. You can grab them. More like, it's not even take a, I mean, it's dine in, you know, but it's the waiting is the hardest part for him. He's a big Tom Petty fan. He says, you know, damn the torpedoes, I'm using eye lasers. He's running down your dream and turning them into nightmares. He's going to stand his ground and he will not back down. They gotta use a wash and get in there and get all the little. Alright. Is this white? What is this? This is silver. That is not what I want. Why do I have so much silver in there? This to be more orangey, so maybe some burnt orange. Some regular orange. And some yellow. This is golden yellow. Got a pale yellow around here as well. Let's go ahead and grab a white, grab some white here. Burnt orange here. We're just gonna start messing about. Like that. So, light source, if the mini is, say, this size, okay, so if they're holding a torch, light coming here, so it's going to be a lot down here, not a whole lot up here. Okay, so most of our lighting is going to be down here. This is where you have to try to figure out, like, yeah, there's torchlight, but where is it coming from? So it's nice to have, say, a PC sized character that you can line up and go, okay, even if they're holding the torch up, like, this guy might be a better representation. He's a little bit bigger. So if he was holding the torchlight up, it's only going to hit, like, here. Well, the rest of this is going to be in shadow. The shadow? Oh, like this is... So here's... This is a candelabra. So if that candelabra... Like, if he was holding it... Yeah, look at that. Okay, so if you zoom out here a little bit. So here's our PC size mini. If he's holding a torch or a candelabra or whatever, that light source is going to be pointed up. That he's not going to be like right next to it. He's going to be like here. So that torch light is going to affect this section right in through here. as far as I'm concerned. That's what where the torchlight's gonna affect. Cool. Yeah, I hope so. So we're gonna try. We're gonna leave a lot of this. We'll probably get some. We'll get some burnt orange back in here, but a lot of this is gonna be still in purples and blues and such. Even back in here is gonna be fairly dark. My take on object source lighting here, basically, from a source that is outside the figure, can be tough. Just gotta figure out where it's coming from so that we can paint it like that. I don't know if we'll get this finished tonight. It's already 8:30, so we'll see. We'll see. I'm gonna be doing lots of mixing here. I saw one of these things. I think it was different. They didn't have all of the eye stalks on. I saw it on the Westphalia miniatures page. And it kind of looked like they just painted them all red. I'm like, oh, it's cool looking. But it needed something to make them pop. And if we're going to have this guy in a cavern, then we want him to look caverny. For sure. Actually, no. can even bring it further up. Almost like a glaze into there. All right, so right now we're gonna mix our regular orange into our burnt orange. Put that down some, bring it over here. Then the highest highlights are going to be down this way, because that, once again, the torchlight is pointing up at this thingy. I have to take into account that the torchlight is coming up, so I gotta do the underneath here. Like so. Here is ambient light reflected off the walls here. brush a little bit back there. Sorry, I need to grab some water. Some regular orange again. Mix it into our already orangey, burnt orange mix just to be a little bit brighter, but not full bright orange yet. Getting closer. The Moose, what's happened, Moose? I don't know if my sound alerts are functioning. Did it work? I have to get them fixed. I've been working on that, but I don't know. No, all good. Okay, just use channel points, man. It's fine. Get them out of there. How you doing tonight, Moes? What's going on? About to start a fresh Baldur's Gate 3 playthrough. Nice. Hope you have fun with that. Lovely bride got me the Baldur's Gate 1 and 2 game because it was released on PS4. And I tried to play the first one. That's tough. It's tough going back to a game that's like 20 years old or something like that and play it. When it's like 8-bit pixels. Hopefully I won't get murdered too hard by one of the beasties I'm painting here. Yeah, hopefully not. I've been stuck on my cowboy fix. I've been playing Red Dead Redemption 2 a lot. Been trying to go through and try and get the highest honor that I can on that game for my latest playthrough. I don't stream that, I just stream mini painting, so you won't ever see me play that. Cause all my video gaming gear is upstairs. And I'm not gonna move it around. That looks pretty cool. I don't know what I need to do. Look at the undersides of these. So, Moes, if you haven't, if you weren't here earlier, basically I'm trying to paint some object source lighting on this guy for when he's coming basically out of the darkness and into torchlight. So all this section here, the front section, is going to be in oranges and yellows and pale yellows and things like that, while the back section is going to be in blues and purples and shadow. So we'll see if I can pull it off or not. I am by no means James Wapple, who can do object source lighting. Like, he's a master at it. Yeah, exactly. And if I pull it off, I'm going to use it in my D&D game. Because that would be awesome. That would scare the crap out of my players. I got some major stuff happening in their game anyway, so this will just add to the terror. I'm just gonna add a little bit up here. Again, just from light bouncing across the walls. Okay, that's pretty bright compared to that. Some blood and ichor on the teeth would make that terrifying. Oh, you know, if he had his mouth open, absolutely. But I think the basing with some skulls down here, we've got a helmet right here, and some broken weapons and wagon wheels and stuff is going to be pretty cool. I can do some other stuff around it as well. All right, so now we're going to go actually straight up orange. We finally get to our bright orange. We've been mixing burnt orange and regular orange into each other to get a kind of more muted red orange. But now we're going to go straight up orange here. And you can see how much brighter this is going to be compared to what we already got. Because it looks pretty bright already, right? But once we start doing this, bright orange in here where we know that torchlight's gonna hit. You know what that smile gives? Give him a psychotic, deep, monstrous laugh as he emerges? Absolutely. Whenever I see something like this and it's big, you know, I almost want to give it that Jabba the Hutt. Ho 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 ho. Uta guta solo. So, and also just to kind of give you a little idea, this is what I'm thinking. Like, this is a regular PC size figure, you know, either holding a torch or a candelabra. It's actually just a mind flayer that I put a candelabra on its arm. But just to kind of give you an idea of, like, where that light source would be coming from as he emerges. Boom, it's going to hit, like, right in through here, right in the face. Yeah, literally out of the dark and in your face with candlelight. Roll initiative, you poor sods. Yep, exactly. Because they are going to be going through a cavern system, so they got to populate it somehow. I mean, it's going to be populated, but there's the Zhentarim are going to be chasing them. Because one of the characters got away from him. And they're not too happy about it. So I have some Zhentarim that's going to be chasing them, along with the Cult of Orcus that the party is chasing to get to the artifact, the MacGuffin, basically. Zensen, Cult of Orcus on your tail can't be good. Yeah, no. No good can come of this. None whatsoever. So now I also need to mix a little bit of this orange into our kind of gray green thing we've got going over here so that we can highlight up the hair because it's gonna get hit by torchlight as well, but not as bad. Is the face. And now we're going to grab some golden yellow. We're just gonna mix that right into our orange. Now we're really gonna start brightening this up. Why do we hell hold a message here? Oh, okay. We'll allow it. We want everybody to see Mo says, "We are about to start a new campaign that I'm running, and I want this big smiling pastor for later in the game. The big bad is a crossroads demon that presents as unnatural smiles and laughter when he possesses something." Well, that's cool. I would definitely go to Westphalia Miniatures and pick this guy up. For sure. He's a resin figure. So he's very light, but you're gonna want to get a base to glue him onto because he's wibbly wobbly. And not like the timey-wimey sense either. He'd fall over on the table if I didn't position him better. task time. Yeah, I wrote a whole rhyming prophecy for the players to uncover and everything. Going to be a fun, scary Lovecraftian-esque time. Nice. Mine hasn't. It wasn't supposed to be a horror game. It was supposed to be more high fantasy, but it kind of turned into a horror game when I was like, well, it's a cult of Orcus that wants to bring him into the material plane. And they're trying to find the horn along with four other artifacts called the Jade Hearts. And they need those to be able to insert them into a certain number of statues. The horn will do it kind of by itself, but to make it permanent, they need these Jade Hearts. And they've been able to find two. They were able to destroy one of... Well, I wouldn't say they destroyed it, but they were able to what am I trying to think of? Kind of disable one of the statues so that it wasn't usable anymore. So now the cult of Orcus is just kind of mad at them. Just mad. Just irritated. But the main leader of the Cult of Orcus was an old vampire, and he is none too happy because they stopped him, and then they chopped him up into little pieces and handed him over to the Zentarum because one of the characters made a deal for being able to, because they were kind of a part of a criminal element, they made a deal with the Zentarum. Hey, if I get you a vampire spawn, will you get me out of this local authority issue in Waterdeep and Baldur's Gate? And they're like, sure, if you can supply us with a vampire spawn, that'd be great. We want one to experiment on. Well, they got him Dusk. She got him Dusk, and which is the Lord Vampire of the and the head of the Orcus cult. And they're like, oh, great, cool. You got him all chopped up. Excellent. And they didn't realize that she hadn't staked him, so when they put him back together, he wiped out their small little cabal in Phandalin. And now he's just angry. And out for a little revenge. So they've got that going for him, you know, which is nice. Alright, gonna mix a little bit more of our golden yellow into our orange mix here. So the Zentarum are mad at the one-player character for giving them a mostly dead vampire lord. The Cult of Orcus is mad at them because they keep thwarting them getting these artifacts. And, yeah. So it's been a fun game. We've been playing since the pandemic started. We started in 2020. And been doing milestones and leveling up slowly but surely because we only play, or at least we try to play once a month. So they're only 9th level right now. Because there's a few months we just don't play, because it's either, people are busy, especially like December, holiday months, November, December. Or, some folks are just out of town on family vacations and whatnot, so. Oh, it's been a ton of fun. I started them off in Phandalin, and I call it the Shadows of Phandalin campaign, because it takes place 10 years after the events in the starter kit. So Phandalin has been built up as a good trading town. More businesses have gotten there. The mines have opened back up. The dwarves are happy. The gnomes are happy. And then, stuff happens. Oh, Lost Mines of Phandalin are great. I ran that through for my Thursday night group. And we had a ton of fun. And I actually really liked the Essentials game too. That was the Dragons of Icespire Peak. Yeah, which again takes place in Phandalin. Kind of like a sequel to that. But so if you wanted to run your characters through that, you could. I would just up the DC and the challenge rating for all of the monsters and stuff, rather than sticking with them at the same, because you should be most of those characters after the Lost Mines of Phandalin. I think they're supposed to be like fifth level, fifth to tenth level, or something like that. We're going with pure gold, yellow now, gold and yellow. Very simple but fun adventure. You completely homebrew when I run campaigns, but I do love to be the player in a pre-made. Yeah, it's fun, especially like going to conventions. Like we're gonna be going to Gamehole Con in Madison in October again. We just got our silver badges with our shirts, and so we're going again in October. I think that's gonna be the main convention that we go to as players, because my wife's a big D&D nerd too. Which is great. But it's always fun to be able to play in somebody else's world for a little bit. You haven't gotten to a con since Gen Con 2019 and you miss it, go to Gamehole Con. It is so much fun. It's all in one big, it's called the Allianz Center or Alliance Center or something like that in Madison, Wisconsin. Hotels are relatively inexpensive. I think you can fly into Madison, so you really don't have to worry about too much of the, unless depending on where your hotel is at, getting stuff, getting transportation there. But there are a lot of really great games and really a lot of great DMs and GMs and storytellers that run some fantastic games at that convention. Take a little bit of this, a little orangey here. Oh, if only you weren't deadly terrified of flying. Oh no. Hey, I tell you what, I was too for quite a while. I did not want to fly in a plane. And then, like, my first flying experience was in, oh Lord, it was probably 96, 96, 97. I think it was 97. And I flew from Seattle-Tacoma Airport down to Denver International. And met a girlfriend of mine there, and for 10 days we hung out and whatever, and then she broke up with me like 3 hours before I was supposed to get back on a plane. So yeah, I flew there with my friend Jeff, and then I flew back by myself, completely heartbroken. And then what was the other time I flew? I flew from, yeah, the next time I flew was from Seattle out here to Minnesota to meet Kim, and then flew back, found out that I'd lost my job, lost my apartment, and my band was breaking up out there. So she bought me another plane ticket and flew me back out here, and I've been here ever since. March 5th in 99 is when I moved out here to Minnesota. And we've been married 25 years come October 9th of this year, so who knew? Works out. Right, so I mixed some pale yellow into our golden yellow. This is going to give us that candlelight, torchlight look here, hopefully. Pick you a Baldur's Gate 3 class. Time to start. You know what? My favorite classes are Ranger and Rogue, with Cleric not far behind. So I would go Rogue. Halfling Rogue. That's my go-to mix or class, I guess I should say. I do have a really cool idea for a paladin cleric that I want to play. Since in some editions you can play multi-classes like that. Halfling. Yep. Yep, gotta love me a halfling cleric or halfling rogue. I also have a halfling ranger that I really enjoy too. So, have fun romancing all those super tall folks there in Baldur's Gate. Yeah, tell me how your halfling romances, what's her name? Big tiefling girl. I was about to say, Moses, I was about to say, I've done the quote unquote love scenes on a dwarf, and that was already awkward with Karlach. Now that's funny. Kind of want to do a half-orc rogue on tabletop with low end and high charisma who isn't proficient in stealth but very high intimidation. His stealth is, you know, see me. There you go. I'm not here. Isn't that just John Cena? Sounds like John Cena. If John Cena ever played D&D, that would be his character. Perfect. Mo says, "Oh my God, we found my next one-shot character." And is it a one shot because that's the only time you get to play him, or one shot because the other players will murder him? That's all right. We're gonna go straight pale yellow here for our final little highlight. Yet to be determined. To be determined. What do you think? Is that? That shows it, right? Nice and dark back here. You can tell more from the side view. Like, oh, it's going to start getting lighter here. But from the front, it's nice and bright. The side, it starts getting further. Okay, I think we're doing okay here. I think I've only done something like this once before, and it was years ago, so I'm. Flying by the seat of my pants, just like I DM. Maz, if you do play that character, you gotta give me credit. Especially if you ever do it on stream. You gotta say Midwest Miniature Guy and I came up with this character. Call him Johann Sienna. Oh, I will. Nice. Chongina. Perfect. Or Chon Jenna, not Gina, Chon Jenna. Perfect. Furiously waving his hand in front of his face, yelling, "You can't see me." Yep. Then all the other players get up and walk out. I'm done. We're not dealing with this crap. I really like the Monument Hobbies Pearl Curl White. It's thinned down enough, you almost don't have to thin it, and it's super smooth. You can really build up. Bright purple and green eye? I don't know, we'll see. I was thinking green for sure. Gotta figure out what to do with all these little eyes, too. My socks is lurking. Hello, my socks. Thanks for the lurk. Oh, hi. What's happening? Blue purple mix here. I need to get back in that section right there. I need to get a fresh paper towel here. Flip this one over or something. Can I flip it over? I can. Okay, awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. There's my light umber. This guy needs a dental plan. Holy cow, look at these things. Thin this down a little bit more. That dry, probably hit it with a wash. What time we got? 9:33. Okay. going to do some of this hair here. Like a gray. Trying to get some of the boring stuff done. That's all I'm going to really do on that hair is just kind of give it that little bit of a gray, blue, yellowy mix. And then I'm going to put some brilliant blue into our Ritterlick blue here. Front here, we're just gonna start highlighting up certain areas that might get hit by some light, make it a little bit lighter, but still in shadow here. Caracas, the halfling rogue is made. Awesome. You'll have to let me know how you do with him. You may be wondering, like, why am I not being overly cautious about what I'm doing here, and I'm just not. I'm just kind of using the side of my brush and grabbing some of the upraised areas to highlight. I figure we'll get a little bit more detailed oriented when we start getting into like highlighting. I know it sounds weird, but like highlighting the shadowed parts. Oh yes. Shadowed areas gets highlights too. First roll of the game to free the intellect devourer, nat 20. This is either a good omen or things go downhill from here. Awesome. It's a good omen, man. I helped you come up with him. It's all good. Go a little bit brighter purple. Do I have my other purple up here? Yeah, I do. It's right there. So I got some Pro-Acryl purple I'm going to mix into my royal purple here. Lazelle for that hot halfling and gif action. Creepy. Can you imagine a githy Yankee halfling mix kid? I don't even know if that's possible. Is that possible? Half Yankee or a Githling? I like half Yankee. It's Sounds like you're from both the North and the South. You're a half Yankee. Considering Gith reproduce asexually and either sex can lay eggs, I doubt it. LOL, but they do have relations for recreation. Well, fair enough. Just for funsies, you know. I did not know that about the reproduction of Gith Yankee. I don't know if I ever knew that. I haven't read the Ecology of Githyanki Yankee for a while. My kids in real life are half Yankee. I'm from Kentucky and the wife's from Pennsylvania. Oh, nice. Oh, you learned it from BJ3. Okay. So all kinds of learning going on here. Hey, you know, things you didn't want to know but were told anyway. My suck says, I made a wizard character that made it to the first romance scene with Lizale just because he was curious. I'm curious. Consider to me curious. It's funny. I haven't played that game before at all, so I wouldn't know. I know it's out there. Just one more game that I would get probably sucked into. It's a lot of fun. Yeah, that's what I hear. What I hear. I've been more into the action adventures rather than role-playing games on for consoles anyway. Like I was saying earlier, I want to go back and replay The Last of Us and the Uncharted series and the Horizon series so far. I know they're making a third one. It's probably going to be for PS5 or PSX. I'm going to have to buy a new system. that's as far as I want to go with the purple, because again, it's going to be it's in shadow, so I don't want to go purple. So I'll go with brilliant blue here. So if you're just coming into the stream, if you're just popped your head in, we're working on a beholder here tonight that is coming out of a cavern into torchlight. So basically, like if you have your PC holding a torch, it's going to get to there, it's lit up its face, everything else is going to be in darkness. So I kind of have to do some object source lighting down here on the base as well with the same colors we used up here. Thankfully I have a wet palette, so I'm hoping that my paints stay nice and wet to be able to do so. But we'll see. I got colors down on this. Holy cow, it's almost 10 o'clock already. And kind of finish up sort of highlighting the tentacles here. Because I don't want to go super bright blue. I'm going to keep it in that shadowy phase here. A little bit of highlights going on here to facilitate them looking like shadows. So I think I want to grab a little bit of this pale yellow. I wonder if this is going to turn green. Oh, nope, it's not. Okay. So we're going to take this. We know that there's still going to be a little bit of light shining on this. See from like the cavern. Walls and or ceiling. See, even that's getting a little too bright. I don't want it to be that bright. That's why I'm just going to put it over the top right here, and I think I'm going to call that done. I think if I go back here, it's going to be too bright. There's still going to be a little bit of light bouncing off the cavern walls. But other than that, I think we're good there. I'm gonna use a little bit of Carandras green here. This is a contrast paint. Okay, so I think that's a pretty good place to stop. We got quite a bit done in those 2 hours. I think we got almost the face all done. We got our shadows established. We got some nice icky purpley green hair coming off of him. So the only thing that we really have left to do, there's still quite a bit, but teeth, we work on the eyes. I missed an eye. And then do the base. So I wanted to show you folks this as well, the other project that I'm working on for my D&D game is. I think I'll use the big camera for this. Well, I can use part of this. Remember when we built this? This is the alien hybrid dragon from Dungeons and Lasers. So I started working on it on Friday, and I'm going for like a white dragon look. And I think what I might be doing is glazing in some light blues into some of this. And then I'll go to the next screen here. Oh, it's gonna get all washed out. But that's how big it is. And I'm gonna put some snow effects on the base. But I was going for kind of like a blue black, blue gray feel with white over the top of it, and then like darker into white wings. And then he's got all these really great. I'll go back to this other scene here. He's got all these really great little nodules that I'm going to do in turquoise, which I've already used a pterodon turquoise for those. You can see there's some down here. Some I've missed. I need to go back and fix that. But yeah, it's a pretty cool model. I'm looking forward to keep working on it. But as for right now, I'm gonna go ahead and end stream. This is just after 10 o'clock. I hope you all have a wonderful rest of your evening. Thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it as usual. We are going to raid Monster Den Minis because he's working on the Guild Minis by Felicia Day. We're definitely gonna raid him. And everybody say hello, give him a follow, and we will catch you all later. Tomorrow, where we'll probably finish up the Beholder, or at least get another good 2 hours of paint time into him. So, have a good night, folks, and as always, happy painting. Bye.